Hello children, I hope you all are doing well and taking good care of yourselves. In today's English lesson, we are going to revise our grammar topic, verbs. Okay, we are going to revise verbs. I hope you remember what are verbs. Any action that is being performed by anyone is called verb. Any action word, for example, here the boy is pouring water in the glass, so pouring, right? Here you can see the boy is singing, so singing is the action here, so singing is the verb. Okay, now here clapping, pushing, collecting, drawing, rapping, so these all are the verbs. Right? What else you learned? You learned to choose a verb in a sentence. For example, the sun shines during the day. Now, what is the action being done here by sun? Shining. So, shines is the verb here. Appa bakes a cake for Amma on her birthday. Bakes. What is the action being done here? Bake. So, bakes is the verb. Remember? So this is the one way you should know how to find out the verb in a particular sentence, right? Another thing you learned, the correct usage of verb. For example, with singular, we have to put S with the verb, but with plural, we don't have to put S. For example, Mr. Patel is singular, so we will put S. So the sentence will be Mr. Patel sells ice cream. Grandma and grandpa. Now they are plural. They are more than one, two people. Grandma and grandpa. So here we will not put S behind the verb. Grandma and grandpa listen or listens? No, it is listen to music. Okay. The tortoise win or wins? Wins, because tortoise is singular. Okay, Sejal and I dash hockey. Now Sejal and I, again two people, so play or plays? Play. Okay, so you have to be very careful while putting S or while choosing the correct form of verb. Okay, you also learned that with singular we use is, and with plural, we use are. For example, book is singular, so we will write is. Dolls, plural, so we will write are. Chair, singular, so is. Roses, plural, so here we will use are. Okay, so this is all we learned about the verbs, usage of is, am, are, and putting S with the verb, or finding out the verb from a sentence, right? On basis of this, I am going to give you one exercise which you have to do in your notebook. You have to do it completely on your own. I will read it once for you, but you have to solve this exercise on your own, right? Number one is underline the verbs. Let me read out the sentences for you. Ria runs very fast. You have to find out the verb. The teacher reads a story. What is the action being performed here? The children are sitting and eating food. The children are sitting and eating food. Now be careful, there can be more than one verb or action words in one sentence. Okay, so you have to choose all of them. It's not that you select only one action. Okay. Read the sentence carefully. You can find more than one verb in a sentence, right? The next part is choose correct form of verb. My friend dash at night walk or walks. Tigers dash very fast. Tigers run or runs. Be careful. Here you have to see that the noun is singular or plural. If the noun is singular like here, so we will put S behind the verb. If it is plural, we don't have to use S with the verb. Next one is Amit and Jia dash dogs, love dogs or loves dogs. The sun dash bright shine or shines. Okay, so this is a small exercise, only 4 plus 3, 7 sentences that you have to do in your notebook. Okay, that's all for today. Bye-bye. Take care of yourself.